Thank you. That concludes the debate on keeping the promise. It's now time to move on to the next item of business, which is an urgent question, and I call Kenneth Gibson.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. To ask the Scottish Government what action it is taking to ensure resilience across the Clyde and Hebrides ferry network this winter, in light of the announcement that the MV Caledonian Isles will continue to be out of service until at least the end of the year.
Cabinet Secretary Fiona Hislop.
It's deeply frustrating and concerning that the community of Arran are facing a further delay to the return of MV Caledonian Isles. Ministers and officials continue to push CalMac to ensure all options to expedite repairs are being considered. CalMac are now looking at what this means in terms of deployment across the network. Three detailed planned options using the route prioritisation matrix have been shared with communities today, and final deployment details will be issued next week. The redeployment of vessels is particularly challenging due to the annual overhaul schedule, but CalMac are committed to ensuring lifeline connectivity is maintained to our islands.
Kenneth Gibson.
I thank the Cabinet Secretary for that response. New vessels expected before the start of winter have yet to arrive. A potential charter has turned out not to be viable. The MV Hebridean Isles is being retired in a few weeks, and now the MV Caledonian Isles may not be back in service until April. This summer was profoundly difficult for islanders and visitors. The winter will now be even more challenging. And despite Arran being the busiest route in the network, my constituents have borne the brunt of this year's disruption. What will the Scottish Government do to ensure that Arran service is as reliable as possible over the coming months? And can the Cabinet Secretary update Parliament on when the MV Glensanex and MV Isle of Islay will enter service?
Cabinet Secretary.
So in relation to that last point, can I say that the Glensanex update was provided to the relevant Net Zero Energy and Transport Committee by the Chair, I think, at period in October. That is still obviously the intention. They're finalising the final elements in terms of that transfer from Ferguson's over to CML for use on CalMac services. But getting to the point of Mr Gibson's question, I recognise the veracity in which Kenny Gibson asked that question and how active he has been in pursuing them. I can understand the frustration that his constituents feel about this issue and the importance of that provision and planning to provide as much resilience as is possible is there, and also recognising the balance between the importance of that route, which he recognises as one of the busiest on the network, with also the responsibilities for lifeline services elsewhere. That's the difficult balancing act in what is going to be a challenging and difficult winter. We thought that last winter would have been the period that would have caused most issue, and we should have been seeing those two, or at least the Glensanex vessel, in by now. We always knew the MV Caledonian Isles would be an integral part of this winter going forward. So I will work with CalMac to ensure we can provide Arran the service services it needs, but also recognise their responsibilities across the network.
Ms Gibson.
I thank the Cabinet Secretary for her further reply. Since the MV Caledonian Isles departed for its annual overhaul in January, the timescale for its return has gone from March to June to August to September to October to mid-November, with no return now in sight as new faults continue to be found despite millions of pounds being spent on repairs. This vessel was also out of service in 2023 for extensive repairs. Islanders are astonished by how badly this has been managed and how much time and money has been spent. What is the Scottish Government doing to hold CalMac to account for these failings?
Cabinet Secretary.
So in relation to the issues, I would recognise that looking at repair and maintenance of ageing vessels has its challenge, but we expect the management and the comprehensive management of that to be done at times of overhaul. But he's correct in identifying, and anybody who wants to see the detail can see it in CalMac's press release, the new and additional issues that have been identified recently on top of the gearbox issues previously. And in terms of going forward, how do you prevent that? Well, you have to ensure that there is regular time for maintenance in all vessels as part of that new contract. And that was precisely one of the conversation points I had when I met with ferry unions recently to identify the things that we would be expecting to see in the forthcoming new contract.
I call Jamie Green.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. have to say, it takes a huge amount of brass neck to stand up in this chamber and ask the SNP government to explain CalMac's failures in all of this. Let me tell you where the failures lie in this entire ferry scandal. It's right there on the SNP front benches. That is the reason. The lack of investment, the lack of progress in new vessels. I haven't heard a single solution from the minister today on what CalMac is going to do to address this situation. They're completely out of vessels and they're completely out of options. And the palpable anger on places like Arran is very real. And I suggest the minister goes and visits the island and talks to the businesses that are losing money hand over foot every single day as a direct result of all of this. There's no point in me asking the minister what she's going to do about this, because the answer is nothing. They've done nothing about this month after month after month. Let me simply ask this. Why has not a single SNP minister lost their job over this fiasco?
Cabinet Secretary.
I think the people of Arran and the constituents of Mr Gibson would not take kindly to the politicisation that has just been expressed. I think, Presiding Officer, attacking other members of this chamber and calling them names or using that kind of pejorative
language is not acceptable.
The member said we're completely out of vessels and completely out of options, which is not true. And had he listened to my first question and the answer to it, I set out that there are three options currently, as we speak, being discussed today. None of them is palatable. I understand that. We want to maximise the route options that we have. But to say what he said is factually incorrect.
Blair Baker.
Thank you. Presiding Officer, I have to say that nobody is surprised that we are here again in the Chamber asking the Scottish Government about mismanagement of ferries. All that has been said today is cold comfort for the residents and businesses of Arran who are facing a winter of disruption as they limp on with an ageing fleet following years of underinvestment and poor planning from the Scottish Government. So why should islanders trust the Government on anything they announce on ferries, given the broken promises, the failure to deliver and the abject lack of leadership which has never resulted in the ferry service that they deserve?
Cabinet Secretary.
So the member, and can I first of all welcome her to her new brief, and clearly whether it's ferries or rail or road, I look forward to engaging with her in the future. But in terms of the government's commitment and in terms of what we are doing, there are six major vessels being delivered to the service which will enhance and improve the position and tackle that resilience and the ageing fleet that she mentions. There are seven new vessels also currently in procurement. That £700 million is a commitment from the Scottish Government that will relieve the pressures that are currently being faced. But everybody recognises there are current pressures being faced, but we are, as I said, commissioning six for major vessels, seven new ones. That is a commitment to our islanders, that's investment, and that should be supported.
Edward Mountain.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The Cabinet Secretary mentioned that the Glen Sannox might offer some comfort, but the latest reports from the yard are that delivery will be imminent. It's been imminent since about 2018, but let's hope it is imminent. Could she clarify, because CalMac are unable to do so, how long it will take to get the Glen Sannox in service from when it's handed over? Will it be 6.5 weeks or 13 weeks? Because we know they've had the crew in place for 2 years. I just can't work out how long it's going to take before the government can get it into service. Perhaps she could clarify, Presiding Officer.
Cabinet Secretary.
So in preparations for the vessel being transferred, it currently is not in the management of CalMac, and that, therefore the preparations in terms of weekly meetings between all the different players to ensure that it can be transferred, that has been happening. He knows that there have been sea trials that have for the most part been successful. In terms of the period of transfer, I think he might be identifying an issue that there has to be a regular annual haul booked in for all vessels, and in consultation with the island community of Arran, their preference was that annual and that scheduled position should be in December. That will have an impact, therefore, on when the vessel will come on stream for regular passenger vessel deployment. And I suspect that is probably the difference that is identified in the points he's been making.
Katie Clark.
The Fraser of Islander Institute estimated that each ferry journey to Arran contributes £13,200 to the Arran economy. What work has been done by the Scottish Government to quantify the cost of these repeated cancellations to both Arran and Ardrossan? And does the Scottish Government have a plan to compensate businesses and the local economy given the ongoing disruption due to the age of the fleet?
Secretary.
So I'm not sure if the member supported this year's budget, but there was a provision in that to help with, particularly with hospitality rates relief, to help support communities and islands, well, particularly islands affected. There was 1,200 businesses that were part of that provision on that hospitality rates relief. In terms of that economic impact, that obviously has been identified in lots of different ways, but not least I had a conversation in a meeting just in the last few weeks with Highlands and Isles Enterprise, and particularly about how working with islands communities we can help try and recover some of that issue. A lot of that is confidence, a lot of that is concern around obviously the headlines that people see, the experience of it, that can obviously be important in raising the issue, but it also has a knock-on and detrimental effect in customer confidence. So we want to be able to rebuild that, and I'm in active discussions with colleagues how we can help islanders in terms of building that forward look, particularly in tourism and supporting tourism businesses on Arran and elsewhere.
Thank you. That concludes the urgent question. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 15227 in the name of Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme, and I call on the Minister to move the motion.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you. No member has asked to speak to the motion. Therefore, the question is that motion 15227 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed.